Thanks so much for coming in for an interview today, Nick. Looks like you've got a really impressive resume here. It says that you made TensorFlow twice as fast. Yes, I've been practicing touch typing every day. I can now write import TensorFlow as TF in 3 seconds flat. Ah, okay, not quite how I was imagining, but that's great to hear nonetheless. And you were published in Nature? Oh, not published. I meant I like to do data science in Nature. It's just something about the outdoors, you know? Huh. And what about this last line? You love working with Transformers? Oh yeah, Optimus Prime is sick. Get out. So you want to break into data science and machine learning, eh? Well, rule number one, don't do what Cheetah Nick in that skit just did. But you're probably thinking, well, what on earth should I do? Well, in this video, we're gonna take a look at exactly that. What's happening, guys? My name's Nicholas Renaud, and in this video, we're gonna be taking a look at the exact repeatable steps that you can leverage to be able to crack the data science, machine learning, and deep learning industry. Now, these steps are gonna be repeatable, so regardless of what industry you really wanna target, you're gonna be able to use exactly these. Ready to do it? Let's get to it. Now, step number one in order to break into the data science and machine learning field is to do your research. So before you decide to actually break into the field, go and take a look at some of the roles that are actually available. Take a look at data scientist roles, data analyst roles, data engineering roles, machine learning engineering roles. Now, first thing you need to do is actually decide whether or not you're actually interested in those particular roles. If you're not, then I'd suggest you stop the video right here and take a break. Okay, you're still interested. Now, once you've started to take a look at the roles, find the ones that you're really, really interested in. And what I want you to do is actually write down what they're asking for in terms of skills, experience, and background. This way, you're going to have a better idea as to how to plan out your plan of attack to actually break into the industry. Now, let's take a look as to how you might actually do this with a live job description. So say, for example, your ultimate dream job and what you wanted to do was to be a data scientist at a company like Nvidia, for example. Well, what you could do is just go to LinkedIn and then type in data scientist. And let's type in Nvidia. And we'll just leave it as worldwide for now. So already we can see that we've got one job description up. Now from here, you can get a whole heap of information about how to plan your plan of attack just from this job description. So you can see here that ideally they're going to need someone that's got a bachelor's, master's or PhD in computer science, electrical engineering, physics, mathematics or other engineering fields. So if you're already in university, this might give you, or if you're planning on going to university or college, this gives you a good idea as to what you're going to want to learn. It also explains what type of experience you're going to need. So 8 years experience as an ML or software engineer. This is obviously for a very senior data scientist. In California, where it's going to be super competitive, but you can start to see that it is telling you what type of experience and what type of skills you're going to need. So you can take all of this information and stack it into your plan in order to start getting ready to break into that field and eventually leapfrog your way to this role. Now, with this newfound knowledge, you can actually begin your plan of attack. This is sort of like flipping the script on its head. You now know what those particular employers want, you can start to build up your repertoire and your CV to be able to match that field. So say, for example, they've asked for experience in a particular field. You can then start to build out your career and try to get experience within that field before you eventually go and apply for that role. Now, obviously, this is a longer term plan, so it's going to set you up for success. But by taking a look at these roles sooner rather than later, you're going to be better positioned to be able to go and chase down that role once you're ready. Step number two, building out your skills and portfolio. Now, building out great skills, particularly in data science, machine learning, and deep learning is great. Don't get me wrong.
Hey, so you're here for the interview as well?
Yeah, pretty cool they got data science roles out, right? Curious, what tools do you use?
Oh, you know, the basics. PyTorch, TensorFlow, OpenCV, and Hugging Face Transformers. What about you?
Oh man, I'm a gun at Stack Overflow. Control C, Control V, all day, baby. But what's most important and the main keyword in that particular statement is actually demonstrating and building out your portfolio. Now, a lot of people spend a lot of time building up skills and learning concepts up to 90% of their available time. But I think one key thing that a lot of people forget is that you need to be able to demonstrate and show your skills and experience. Now, a great way to do that is to show it through a particular portfolio. So here's what I want you to do in this particular step. for everything that you go on and learn from here on forward, what I want you to do is take that particular thing that you've gone and learned and start to build out a project that's interesting to you. Once you've built out that project, what you're going to want to do is actually create a GitHub repository, document it really, really well. Explain your results, explain why it's important, and explain how it's going to change the world. Once you've got that GitHub repository together, what I want you to do is share it through social media. Share your experience, share what you learned, share how you'd make it better, and explain what you're doing in that particular industry. This not only allows you to learn a particular concept, but it also allows you to demonstrate your experience out to the broader field and out to the industry. This just makes it one step further to establishing your reputation within the data science, machine learning, and deep learning field, and it's gonna make it a whole heap easier for you to crack the industry and land a job. Step number three, start speaking to people in the industry. Now, I'll never forget when I first started out my career, I was actually working in finance. And everybody used to always say, Nick, go out and network. Hey Chad, heard you just landed a role as a data engineer. Congratulations. Yeah man, pretty cool, right? Any tips on landing a role? Oh man, you gotta network. You gotta network all day. Network all day. But people like Chad never really actually tell you how to network. So I'm gonna give you my secret formula. Now, what I want you to do the next time that you're going to a meetup or the next time that you reach out to someone on LinkedIn to try to network, what I want you to do is treat it as though they are actually interviewing you at that point in time. So this means I want you to go and do your research on that particular person, find out what it is they're working on, find out what industry they're currently operating in, and then I want you to ask them these three questions. So I want you to ask them what it is that they find most challenging about that particular task that they're currently tackling. They'll give you a whole bunch of examples about challenges within the field and what are the particular advancements that are operating in that field. And then once they give you a lot of information about that, I want you to ask them, how are you going about solving that particular problem? What are some of the technologies and techniques that you're actually leveraging to be able to go and perform or solve that particular problem that they're currently working on? Then they'll give you a bunch of information about how they're actually going about solving that. And again, pay attention to what they're telling you because this information is really, really important. The best way to go about getting a whole heap of experience and a whole heap of knowledge is to speak to people that are already inside it. So take all of this information on. Then once they've given you that information, the last thing that I want you to ask is, how does this fit into the broader data science ecosystem? So once they've actually gone and built this particular model or developed this particular thing, how is this going to be used or implemented in the field? So this gives you the ability to demonstrate that you're interested in what it is they're doing, you're interested in how they're going about solving certain challenges, and you're interested in the broader impact of what it is they're actually working on. So this allows you to demonstrate that you're interested in them. You want to know what it is they're talking about. Now, ultimately, what they're going to do is they're going to start asking you what you're interested in, what you're working in. So have some really good answers prepared for that. So explain the projects that you're working on from step number two and give them background. Tell them what you're working on, what you're interested in, and what your challenges are and how you're hoping to better serve the world. Step number four, develop your edge. So if you've got to step four, by now what you should know is what's happening in the industry and what the job requirements are for a particular role. You've also started establishing your skills and building up your portfolio, and you've started networking and speaking to people in the industry. So now, how do you go and stand out? A key thing to note is that there is a huge demand for people in the data industry, whether or not that be data scientists, data analysts, machine learning engineers, deep learning engineers, or data engineers. There is a ton of demand, so you need to do something to stand out. Now, funnily enough, this is easier than it sounds. The great thing about data science, data analytics, or the whole industry is that it is so broad and it crosses a whole range of different businesses and domains. One great way to develop your edge is to develop an industry edge. So if you've already got industry experience or if you've worked within a particular industry, you can begin to specialize within that field and leverage your data science skills within that particular field. Now, another way to develop an edge is to develop a technology edge. So rather than focusing on just being a stock standard or cookie cutter data scientist, what you can begin to do is broaden out your skill set. So whilst you might be really, really good at data science, machine learning, and deep learning, you might choose to also tack on something like data engineering. So you can build full data pipelines and bring those in to your data science workflow. One other example of this is being a more of a full stack data scientist. So say for example, you've got experience in software engineering or web development. you can actually bring those skill sets and combine them with your data science skills to be able to truly stand out in the industry. Now, in my particular case, I've got a little bit of full stack experience, and I've also got some industry experience, particularly in finance and business operations. So I'm able to bring those together to truly stand out when it goes to applying for data science roles. And that's exactly what I want you to do as well, because that's gonna help you develop your edge and stand out from other candidates in the industry. Step number 5. Cast a wide net and get some experience. Now, a key thing to note is that having experience is quite possibly the most important thing when it comes to actually breaking into data science, machine learning, or deep learning. Having some real life business expertise within the field is absolutely priceless. Now, what this may mean is that you're not able to go for your dream role automatically. That's okay, you can build up to that. By first up stepping into a role which is going to allow you to get a foot in the door, you're going to be able to get experience, learn things at an appropriate pace, but also develop industry connections within that company. Now, this is a bit of a stepping stone approach. So you'll get your foot in the door and then you can start to progress further towards the dream job that you've always wanted. Now, a key thing to note is that there are so many different types of roles that can eventually lead you to your dream data science or machine learning or deep learning role. You can take a look at junior data science roles or data analyst roles, data engineering roles. If you have a specific preference for a particular field, you might take a look at NLP specific roles, computer vision roles. There are a whole bunch of different types of jobs out there in the industry which are easier to get into than the prestigious data science or machine learning engineer roles. Taking a step back and allowing yourself the time to build up that experience to be able to go for that dream job is going to make your life so much easier. And again, it's going to make you stand out because you've got experience in the industry already when it comes to going for that true dream role. Step number 6, rinse and repeat. Oh, you thought we were done after that last step? Oh, hell no. Once you've gone through this process once, what I'm gonna want you to do is rinse and repeat it. So say, for example, you start off in a data analyst role, but your dream job is stepping all the way through to something which is like a senior data scientist. Well, this exact set of steps that we've discussed is exactly what you're gonna wanna do to progress further onwards. Take a look at the roles that you wanna perform, build up your skills and experience, develop your portfolio, speak to more people in the industry, and again, build up your experience to be able to get to that role. So this gives you a repeatable set of steps to not only break into the industry, but pursue the ideal career or the ideal position that you eventually wanna get to. So for example, I actually did this myself. So a long time ago, I was actually a chartered accountant. So I worked in a finance team doing management accounting. Now what I did is I went through this exact same process. So I looked at the roles that I wanted to be in, I built up my experience, spoke to people, and then I eventually transitioned into a business intelligence role. From there, again, I did the exact same repeatable pattern and I transitioned into a data consultant role. Again, did the same pattern again and eventually landed up where I am now as a data scientist. So again, going through these set of steps is going to allow you to not only break into the industry, but progress and eventually get your dream role. Now that about wraps it up. So those 6 key steps are going to allow you to not only break into the industry, but also establish yourself as an amazing data scientist or machine learning engineer, or really anyone that's operating in the data space. Hopefully this has been useful for you. On that note, that about wraps it up. Thanks so much for tuning in, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe, and tick that bell, and let me know what else you'd like to see and how these steps helped you to be able to crack into the data science or machine learning industry. And if you've got any other suggestions, by all means, do leave a mention in the comments below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Thanks again for tuning in. Peace.